guys, and welcome back to Orange County Incubation and Embryology Project. I'm Maggie Smith, your Animal Science Program Manager, and we are on day two of our project, Parts of the Egg. But before we get started today, I have a very special guest with me.
Hello, my name is Riley. I'm a part of the 4-H Club.
Are you ready for Incubation Embryology?
Yeah!
Welcome back to 4-H Incubation and Embryology. Today is lesson two, parts of the egg and why they're so important. So, let's go over our rules. Rule number one is do nothing. Rule number two is if we have to do something, we wash our hands. Our checklist for the day is, did we wash our hands? Did we make sure our incubator works? Have we added water? And is the temperature 99.5 to 100 degrees Fahrenheit? I think it's time for us to get learning.
Now let's wash our hands.
Awesome. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Wow. Scrub, scrub. All right, scrub, scrub, scrub. We scrub the tops of our hands. We scrub the bottoms of our hands. All set?
Almost. I gotta get these parts.
Yes, you do. You gotta get them all nice and dry. Close enough. All right, let's start class.
Let's start class.
Awesome. Riley, so how many days do our chickens have until they hatch? What's that number?
I hear
18.
18.
What's this number?
25.
25. All right. So, is our water filled?
Yep. Got two of them.
All right. Is our incubator safe?
Yeah.
Okay. Is our temperature where it's supposed to be?
Yeah.
Okay. So, are you ready to get started?
Yeah.
So how does an egg work? To understand how an egg works, we need to dive deeper into what each individual part brings to our developing embryo. The egg has many parts, and each part has an important function during the development of our chick.
Awesome, so tap it again. Okay, now open it. Yep. Ready, we're just sticking our fingers.
That's scary.
So cool.
It's getting in my head.
No.
Germinal disc is where fertilization occurs and the chick begins to develop. The germinal disc is the white spot located right on top of the yolk. This is where the female genetic material is found.
What are you pointing at?
The germ disc.
The germ disc. This is the part of incubation and embryology where the cells divide and create the embryo.
Yolk. The yolk provides food for the embryo. It is made up of fats, carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, and minerals. My favorite fact about the yolk is that when the chick is developing, the last part of its body to close is the abdomen. It sucks up the rest of that remaining yolk and ensures that it will survive for up to 2 days without food or water.
Riley, what's this?
The yolk.
What's the yolk?
The yolk is the chick's food.
Wow.
Albumen or white. The albumen, or the white, cushions the egg yolk floating within. It is the main source of protein and water for the embryo. Fun fact, this is the only part of the egg that smells because it contains sulfur.
So this part of the egg is called the albumen or the white. It contains vitamins, minerals, and water.
It's actually the only part of the egg that smells because it contains sulfur. Riley's gonna demonstrate how you properly, scientifically smell something. That's called wafting. Chalaza. The chalaza are the cords on either side of the yolk that keep the yolk floating in the center of the albumen. It's also known as the twisted white ties. As you can see from that picture, it looks like almost braided white rope. The chalaza, or twisted white ties, are located on either side of the yolk sac. These keep our yolk anchored in place so that when our chick develops, it's constantly in the center of the egg, which is the safest part. Shell membrane. The inner and outer membrane found between the eggshell and the egg white keep the bacteria from entering the egg and help to slow evaporation from the moisture of the egg. So it provides protection, calcium for the bones, and allows gases to exchange. Shell. It's our first line of defense against bacteria and is actually the strongest shape in the world. When we do our science experiments in our upcoming lessons, you guys will be able to see just how strong those shells are. The shell has more than 7,000 tiny pores that allow oxygen to pass into the egg and carbon dioxide to escape. Riley, what part of the egg are you looking at?
We're looking at the shell and the membrane.
Okay, and what does it feel like?
A balloon.
The membrane feels like a balloon. Can I get up close to that? All right, and what about the shell?
The shell.
Is it soft or hard?
Hard.
Hard. Do you know what the shell and the shell membrane do for the embryo?
Keep the chick protected.
Very good. Air pocket. The air pocket or air cell is located between the inner and outer membrane at the large end of the egg. It holds oxygen for the chick to be able to breathe. This is the most important part of the egg when we're candling. It allows us to shine light through the egg to check on the development of our chick. So let's explore what's happening inside of our eggs while we were learning. Day 20. Growth begins in the yolk sac. The circulatory system, vertebrae, and organs begin to form. So with 19 days to go, blood vessels appear in the yolk sac. Formations of veins and the heart starts to beat. And today, while we were learning about parts of the egg, we have 18 days to go. Today, the beaks, wings, legs, begin to form.
Thanks for joining me, Riley.
Catch her on the next episode of Incubation and Embryology.
See you guys soon.